So in this video, we'll be studying about some other features of central force. So what are the consequences of conservation of energy? We know that kinetic energy of a particle is nothing but half mv square. Here we have a reduced mass mu. So the kinetic energy of a mass mu is half mu v square. So v has two components, one in the radial direction, another in the tangential direction. So we substitute it as r dot unit vector r plus r theta dot unit vector theta whole square. On expanding this, you get the equation of kinetic energy as half mu r dot square plus r square theta dot square. Now we know that all the central forces are conservative, so we can associate a potential energy u of r with f of r. So the relation will be like this. The work done in bringing a particle from Ra, some distance Ra, to R is defined as, the work done is defined as U of R minus U of Ra is equal to minus of integral Ra to R f of R dr. So that work done, the amount of work done is transformed into, or it is in the form of potential energy of the particle at the position R. So this term U of Ra, we take it as zero, we assume it as zero. There is no effect on this on adding a constant with the energy term, so we neglect it as zero. Okay, now from the work energy theorem, we have total energy, total mechanical energy will be the sum of kinetic energy and the potential energy. So we substitute kinetic energy and potential energy as half mu v square plus u of r. So we substitute v as half mu r dot square plus r square theta dot square plus u of r. This equation gives the total mechanical energy, which is a constant. Now we can eliminate theta dot from this equation by using the relation for angular momentum. L is equal to mu r square theta dot square. So we substitute theta r square theta dot r theta r square theta dot as L by mu. So on substituting here, you get the equation for energy as half mu r dot square plus half L square by mu r square plus u of r. So this equation says this is the total energy of a particle moving in a single direction, or it is a one dimensional motion. So there is no presence of theta in this equation. Okay, so this equation is similar to the energy, total energy of a particle moving in one dimension. Now in this equation, we treat these two terms, these two terms as, collectively we term it as the effective potential energy. So U effective R at a position R is equivalent to half L square by mu R square plus U of R. So our total energy, on substituting this in the form of U effective, the total energy will be half mu R dot square plus U effective. So U effective is called the effective potential energy or effective potential, and the term, this term L square by 2 mu r square, which is a term in the effective potential, this term is called the centrifugal potential. This term contains the element of theta, and this U of r is called the true potential. So our total energy E is equal to half mu r dot square plus U effective. Okay,